Hello everyone, in this video I'm going to show you how you can host a static website on Amazon S3. But before we do that, let's first take a look at what S3 is. Well, S3 is a cloud storage service built by Amazon which allows you to store an unlimited number of files in the cloud. And being the cloud, you of course only pay for what you use. So why would you use S3 instead of a regular web host? Well, first of all, S3 has great performance. It's also very secure, since you don't have PHP or MySQL database running that can be compromised. It's low cost in the sense that you only pay for what you use, and it can scale very, very, very well. It can scale from one request per second to dozens of requests every single second. So what's next in this tutorial? I'm going to show you how you can create a bucket. We're going to enable the static website hosting feature for that bucket. We're going to set a bucket policy allowing all our files to be accessed through a browser, and then we're going to test our website and see if it actually works. So let's begin. So for the purpose of this video, I've created a simple website that I'm going to host on S3. It's called My Awesome Website, and this is what it looks like. It's basically two simple pages with Hello World. This is My Awesome Website's homepage. There's even a second page which you can check out here, and you can click and then it navigates to page2.html, and then you can go back if you want, back to the homepage. Okay, so let's now host our static website on Amazon. So let's go to the AWS management console, which is at console.aws.amazon.com. And I'm gonna open up the S3 management console here. So as you can see, I have a lot of buckets where I can store files. And for my website, I'm gonna create a new bucket. So I'm gonna click create bucket, and I'm gonna call it www.myawesomewebsite.com, and I'm gonna leave the region by default Ireland. I live in Europe, so this is a very good region. I'm not gonna set up logging, so I'm just gonna go for create here, and Amazon is now creating my bucket, and boom, there you have it. My bucket has been created. So the first thing that we're gonna do is we're gonna enable static website hosting for this bucket. So I'm gonna click on static website hosting, and I'm gonna click enable. And now Amazon wants to know what our index and error documents are. So my index document is very traditional. It's called index.html. And my error document is called 404.html. These are two files that should be in this bucket for the website to work. So I'm going to click save. And right now, my bucket and my website is accessible through this URL. So it's called www.myawesomewebsite. And then some URL that Amazon generates. So if I click on it, I see 403 forbidden. That's pretty logical because there's nothing in the bucket yet. So let's go into the bucket. Let's click on the name. And I'm going to upload some files. So here I'm going to say add files. And I'm going to select all my files here, my HTML files. Now you can actually upload folders to this, but we're going to do that manually. Okay, so there are my files. Now I'm going to create a folder CSS. And in that folder, I'm gonna upload my style sheet. And click style.css, click choose, upload. And there you have it. So my website is completely uploaded to Amazon S3. Now let's take a look if that website is already up and running. So let's go to my website, I hit refresh, and no, I still got 403 forbidden. Why is that? Well, Amazon makes sure that all the files that you upload are not publicly accessible straight away. This is a security feature. So you have two choices. Either you can make every file public, which you can do. You click on a file, you open its properties, and then you can set the permissions and you can allow anyone to get your object. Or you can do this instantly for all files in your bucket. I think that's a much nicer solution, so let's go for that. So to do that, let's click on your bucket name here, and let's go to the properties, which is by default selected, and we're going to select permissions, and we're going to add a bucket policy. Okay. So now Amazon asks you, hey, which policy do I have to add? Well, I've already created a policy here, which is stored on my desktop, and this is the policy that you need to make all files in your bucket publicly accessible. Now, I will share this in the video's description. So basically what you're saying is that we're allowing anyone to read or get an S3 object, and we're going to allow it for all files in this bucket, which is the name of my bucket, www.myawesomewebsite.com/star. So let's save that. And let's save here as well. And now if I'm going to go back to my website and I hit refresh, sure enough, there's my website, Hello World. And I can navigate to the other page, and I can navigate back, and all is very well. Now let's also test our error document. So here we navigate to index.html. Let's say I want to go to blah, blah, blah.html, which is a file that does not exist. If I hit enter, Amazon automatically redirects me to my error document. I created this file, 404, oops, page gone missing, the requested page could not be loaded. And so that's it. We hosted our static website on Amazon S3. I hope you enjoyed this video. Thanks for watching.